Before 1992, before I ever touched a computer, I played a lot of games on the NES. And on the NES, one of the most fascinating things to me were the password generators. I am Bisqwit, and in this series we explore how old games generate their passwords. Today we study the passwords of Bubble Bobble. Bubble Bobble is one of the 29 games that will be re-released in November this year on the Nintendo Classic Mini. To begin off, we generate a blank password by feeding the cute little dragon to the... whatever those are, and we get the password for level 1. Bob. Now, on a cursory examination, it may look like these passwords are hard-coded into the game like in Gremlins 2, but learning two things will change your mind. First is that you can modify the password, and nearly everything you try will produce a new valid password. Secondly, if you look at walkthroughs for this game, you learn that there are over 100 levels for this game. It is just not feasible for game developers to waste expensive ROM estate for huge password tables. And foremost, it would hurt the pride of developers to use a table of passwords, so it stands to reason that there is an actual algorithm behind here. Now, in my youth, I was never able to discover the logic behind the passwords. But now that I am in the future, I can take a look at the game ROM and learn what the game actually does. Using the romhacking.net RAM map for this game, I learned that the game stores password letters in RAM addresses 502 through 506. I disassembled the game ROM and searched for code that deals with these RAM addresses in particular. After a couple of hours, I had a pretty good understanding of what the code does. Here it is. You can pause the video here if you want. The first part of the code deals with generating the password, and the second part deals with decoding and verifying one. Let's work through the whole thing. First things first. The passwords are actually 5-digit numbers. The letters that you enter and read on the password screens are actually numbers, and not only that, it is a substitution cipher, where each letter corresponds to some particular digit. Here are examples of some known passwords and how they actually are in numeric form. Now, it is very important to keep in mind that the password is comprised of 5 digits, that is, 5 numbers that are treated individually. This is an important distinction to keep in mind because from now on, we are going to operate on individual digits or letters of the password in binary form. The next layer of protection is exclusive OR convolution. It is a reversible operation that mixes up bits in the letters. We will get back to this later. Here is a sample of how a password is decomposed into the 5 digits by undoing both the substitution cipher and the XOR convolution. The next step is the most interesting part. This is the final part of the password decoding process and the first part of the password encoding process. Here each letter is decomposed into bit fields. The level number is split into 3 bit fields, which are stored in the first 3 letters. The flag that indicates whether this is a Super Bubble Bobble game is stored in the next letter. The same letter also stores something. Something is a 2-bit variable of unknown purpose. I do not know what the game uses it for. Finally, there's a checksum that is split into 2 fields. The low order 3 bits are stored in the final letter, and the remaining 2 bits are stored in the center letter. The checksum is simply calculated by adding all the letters together, excluding the checksum itself. Let's try in practice how this works. Say we want a level 77 password for regular Bubble Bobble, where something is 3. First, we convert these numbers into binary, and then we start inserting these bits from those numbers into the letters. The bits from level number go into letters 0, 1, and 2. The super flag goes into letter 3, and so does something. When we add these numbers together, we get 14. The checksum is converted into binary and inserted into letters 2 and 4. Now that we know all the digits of the password, next we have to do the XOR convolution and finally the substitution cipher. The password is GI. Here is another example, level 1 of Super Bubble Bobble, where something is 3. The password becomes BBFG. Now, let's take a step backwards. Remember when I said that each letter in the password is a 4-bit number? So far, the game has been dealing with 3-bit numbers, but they are actually 4-bit. We have been playing nice so far, going by the rules of the game. Now it's time to break out! The actual formula used by the password decoder looks like this. In the bitmask format we can make a few observations. Let's skip the level number for now. The super flag is now a 2-bit number. Super flag 0 means regular bubble bubble. Super flags 1, 2 and 3 means super bubble bubble. In other words, the game only cares of whether it is 0 or non-zero. Too bad. Now about something. I have found exactly one use for something. If you go to level 100 and something is 0, the final boss battle will trigger. If something is non-zero, the boss battle will not trigger. In any case, if you go to level 113 or higher, the final boss battle will always trigger. I do not know for sure, but I theorize that something is an indicator for which ending you are going to get. I haven't played this game much, and whatever little I know of actual gameplay is based on playing it as a child and reading some walkthroughs just now. Now about level numbers. Even though the range of valid level numbers in this game is 1 through 113, it is actually possible to craft passwords where the level number is in range 0 to 159. But this cannot be used to break the game. The game automatically turns level 0 into level 1 and starts the final boss battle on any level number higher than 112. Finally, some of these bits overlap. This means that in some cases multiple different passwords may produce the identical outcome. Once again I created a little program. This PHP program will walk through all the 100,000 different passwords, trying to decode them like the game would. And if the decoding succeeds, lists those passwords. In other words, it will list all valid passwords recognized by the game. The number of those passwords is 2868. Way too much to list in this video, but here is a sample of the program's output. I am In the next episode we will have another game to study. It may contain trace amounts of dinosaurs. Then again, it may not.